I'd like to call this meeting to order. And our first order of business is the approval of the minutes for November 9th and January 11th. Do I hear any discussion from the Senate regarding the minutes? Does anybody have any points to raise regarding the minutes? So I'll first call for the approval of the November 9th minutes. All in favor, say aye. Opposed, nay. Abstain. And now for the approval of the January 11th minutes. All in favor, please say aye. Nay. Abstain. So moved. The minutes for November 9th and January 11th are approved. Our next point of business is the State of the University. We're thrilled to have our president, Robert Berdahl, here to give his second address to the university community. And afterwards, he'll take comments and questions from audience members. As you can see, we have mics that are set up here in the front and then here in the middle of the auditorium. So please welcome Bob.
Thank you, Rob. I'm going to keep my remarks today relatively brief. The main topic for the discussion today is the presidential search, once again, with input from all of you about what you would like to see in the next president. And I'll make a few observations about that search and what I would like to see in the next president. One of the things I'd like to see in the next president is him being here on schedule, or she being here on schedule in September. Let me just make a few comments about the state of the university. First of all, as you know, there's a great deal of discussion about the University of Oregon, along with other institutions in the state system, securing independent boards, those who wish for independent boards, as this university has thus sought one. Yesterday, the House committee passed by a vote of 7-1, the House Committee on Higher Education, with only one dissenting vote, House Bill 4061, a bill that will create a special legislative committee with members of the legislature and members of the Oregon Education Investment Board to make a report about the steps that will be necessary to achieve independent boards. That bill will be passed to the Ways and Means Committee and considered by the Ways and Means Committee and then pass on to the Senate. And the intent of the bill, at least as I read it, and I think we have had a good deal of conversation about this bill with members of the Lane County delegation, is to create a clear path for the creation of institutional boards in 2013. It has passed the committee with bipartisan support, and we hope to see it advance through Ways and Means and to the Senate in the course of the session that is ongoing through the month of February. Let me talk just a few moments about the university and its search for a president. As you know, a search committee has been appointed. We have secured the services of a search firm whose representatives are here today to listen to this conversation and to talk to people on campus. And I want to talk not so much about what we are looking for, because you all can answer that question. I want to talk about what I think candidates will be looking for, because I think that's an equally important question as we consider having an independent board, as we consider the future of this university, the kind of business model that the university has for itself going forward. It seems to me that the process of recruiting a president is not simply our seeking someone, but they're seeking us as well. So that it is a two-way street, and the kind of presentation. Looking at this university to be optimistic about the future. I think that there is a very strong basis for that optimism, not only because I think we have very important discussions going on about the governance structure of the university, but we have also, I think, a very good set of conversations that are underway that I have been a part of and others have been a part of, about the support that the university has in the broader community, especially in the broader community of donors. So this is, I believe, a really opportune moment. The institution, as I think you have felt it, has a great deal of momentum.